read your book, one listen to this tape. When you hear this sound, you'll know it's time to turn over the page. Listen to that sound again. Now it's time for our story, The Cow and the Moon. One fine Monday morning, Mr. Squiggle met a cow. Good morning, said Mr. Squiggle. But the cow was too sad to say anything except, Oh dear, said Mr. Squiggle, what's wrong? The cow came up very close to Mr. Squiggle and whispered, Tonight it's my turn to jump over the moon. Hooray, cried Mr. Squiggle. I love jumping over the moon. Let's do it together. But I'm too scared to jump over the moon, said the cow sadly. I've never done it before, and I don't know how to start. Never mind, said Mr. Squiggle, who was already drawing something. What is it going to be? Asked the cow, watching closely. Why, it's a sunflower. You start by jumping over this sunflower, said Mr. Squiggle. Why don't you try? So the cow took a deep breath and jumped. Hooray, said Mr. Squiggle. Hooray, said the sunflower. Did you see that, said the cow, and she jumped over the sunflower again. Then the cow stopped jumping and said sadly, But I'll have to jump a lot higher than that to jump over the moon. Mr. Squiggle began to draw again. The cow and the sunflower watched closely. What is it going to be? Is it a mountain? Is it a bus? Is it a fountain? You're drawing an elephant, said the cow. I can't jump over an elephant. But Mr. Squiggle kept on drawing. He seems a very nice elephant, said the cow doubtfully. He is a very nice elephant, said Mr. Squiggle, and he's very small for an elephant. I'm only a baby, said the elephant in a baby elephant voice. He's still a lot bigger than a sunflower, said the cow. But Mr. Squiggle and the sunflower and the baby elephant all said, Why don't you try? So the cow took a deep breath and jumped. Hooray, said Mr. Squiggle. Hooray, said the sunflower. Hooray, said the baby elephant. Did you see that? Said the cow. I did it. And she jumped over the baby elephant until she was quite out of breath. Then the cow stopped jumping and said sadly, But I'll have to jump a lot higher than that to jump over the moon. Mr. Squiggle was so busy drawing that he didn't even hear. The cow watched closely. What is it going to be? You're drawing a giraffe, said the cow. squiggle and the sunflower and the baby elephant and the giraffe all said, "Why don't you try?" So the cow took a deep, deep breath and jumped. "Did you see that?" said the cow. "I did it! I did it!" "Hooray!" said Mr. Squiggle and the sunflower. "Hooray!" said the baby elephant and the giraffe. It was getting late in the afternoon. The sun set and the sunflower closed her petals and went to sleep. But there was no moon. The cow gazed sadly at the sky and said, "The moon isn't there. It's lonely without it." But up in the sky, Mr. Squiggle was spacewalking and drawing. The cow watched closely. Then she became quite excited. "I know," she said. "You're drawing a moon." "I'm going to jump over the moon," cried the cow. "I am, I am, I am." So she took a deep breath and jumped. "Did you see that?" cried the cow. "I did it, I did it, I did it." "Hooray," said Mr. Squiggle, and he jumped over the moon too. And would you believe it? The cow was never afraid to jump over the moon again. Are you ready for our next story? Our story is called The Best Nest. This is the story of Selena, the scarlet spotted spindle bird. Selena was very proud of her new eggs. They were scarlet, just like Selena. They were spotted, just like Selena. And they were very pretty, just like Selena. But they were big, and they were heavy. "They're getting much too big for this nest," thought Selena. "I think I'll have to find a bigger one." So she put her pretty, scarlet, spotted eggs in her string bag. One egg. Two eggs, three eggs, four eggs, lots and lots of eggs, and off she flew. She hadn't gone far before she noticed that her eggs seemed bigger and heavier than ever. "Oh dear," thought Selena, "I hope I find a new nest soon." Just then, she saw something big and round lying on the ground. It was bright and shiny and strong, and it had a very useful looking handle. Selena flew down and landed on the handle of a frying pan left behind by a careless camper. "Just the thing for a nest," said Selena as she put down her pretty scarlet spotted eggs. "One egg, two eggs, three eggs." But oh dear, how cold and hard it was, Selena thought. "I'll have to find something much more soft and comfortable for my eggs," she said. So Selena gathered up all her eggs, put them back into her string bag, and flew off again. She flew and she flew and she flew until she saw a small, fluffy white cloud. a wonderful nest. She flew straight up and landed right on it. Selena unpacked her pretty scarlet spotted eggs. One egg, plop. Two eggs, plop. Three eggs, plop. But, oh dear, they were sinking right through the cloud. Just in time, Selena rescued them. What a narrow escape for her poor eggs. Selena felt quite faint. Clouds don't make good nests for the big, heavy eggs of a scarlet-spotted spindlebird. Will I ever find the right nest? Selena wondered. Then, away in the distance, she saw Mr. Squiggle. He was spacewalking down from the moon to visit Selena and her new eggs. Is about a pumpkin, and while I tell you the story, you can read the words in your book and look at the pictures. Now for our story, Peregrine the Pumpkin. Peregrine the Pumpkin was a very small pumpkin with a very big problem. What was he going to be when he grew up? Every morning he had a new idea. But the other pumpkins laughed at him so much that he had always changed his mind by morning tea time. On show day, they were still laughing.
"You're much too small to win a prize, Peregrine," they called as they hurried off to the show.
Peregrine sighed and looked up at the sky, and there was Mr. Squiggle sitting on a cloud.
"Just the person I need," thought Peregrine, and he called out,
spacewalked down towards him as quickly as he could. "I love problems," he said. "What is it?" Peregrine told him. He had so many exciting ideas about what he wanted to be, but the other pumpkins always laughed at him.
"Why, just this morning I thought what fun it would be to be a scarecrow."
"I could turn you into a scarecrow," said Mr. Squiggle.
"Could you really?" cried Peregrine. "Oh, please try."
So Mr. Squiggle got to work, and in no time at all, Peregrine was a big, scary scarecrow.
"There," said Mr. Squiggle, "how does that feel?"
"It's all right," said Peregrine doubtfully. "But all the birds are flying away from me. They're frightened." "Well," said Mr. Squiggle, "that's because you're a scarecrow."
"Then perhaps I'd better be something else," said Peregrine.
"Something friendly. All right, said Mr. Squiggle. What would you like to be? Well, said Peregrine, I like people and excitement and... I know what I want to be. I want to be Cinderella's coach. You do, said Mr. Squiggle. Are you sure? Oh, yes, said Peregrine. It will be great fun. So Mr. Squiggle turned Peregrine into a coach, and then he drew some friendly mice to pull him along. It's just what I've always wanted, said Peregrine, and I don't care if the other pumpkins do laugh at me. At last, the other pumpkins came home from the show. They'd won lots of ribbons and prizes for being big, important pumpkins. But when they saw Peregrine, they stared in amazement. Then they all started shouting, Peregrine, can we have a ride? Please, Peregrine. But, sorry, said Peregrine. Later, said Mr. Squiggle, who was the coach driver. And with a great swirl of dust, the friendly mice galloped off with the coach to meet Cinderella. Cinderella's coach arrived. Everyone cheered. Mr. Squiggle, whispered Peregrine, I think that being a coach is the most exciting thing that's ever happened to me. Then Mr. Squiggle and Peregrine and the mice all joined in the party and had the most wonderful time they ever had.